We've hit the record. Again, one of the biggest things that they don't tell you is make sure you document your journey. You never know how it's going to serve you later on. All right? So, my journey is very different than a lot of the announcers that we heard from today. I had no ambition to be in media. I didn't even want to film a video. All right? You're hearing an accent. I'm from Canada. Well, I was born in Trinidad, spent my life in Canada. And I moved here right about the beginning of 2014. My journey started because when I came to Trinidad, I used to work at Apple back in Canada. I used to work at a company called TELUS, which is like Digicel, but back in Canada. And I love technology. I used to teach technology and how to use your devices when I used to be at Apple, when I used to be at TELUS. So when I came to Trinidad, I remember going to Trin City Mall, and I wanted to check out the tech scene here in Trinidad. See, what are the popular phones that are, how are people selling, what the tech space is like in Trinidad. So I won't call the company's name, but I went to a company that was the color of this drape, right? That one. I walked in, and I was listening to a conversation with a rep and a customer. And at that time, the S4 was the big phone everybody was chasing. And the customer asked one question. Is this phone waterproof? Now, I'm just listening. I'm eavesdropping. I don't know the answer. No, it's not. Can't bring that phone anywhere near water. And do you know what the rep said?
Yes.
Yep. You think you know. But the rep, whatever you think, he 10x that. The man said, if it could go in water, boy, this phone, you could go and dive in the bottom of the ocean. You could find Nemo with this phone. You could pelt it in water, do what you want. This phone is not going to mess up. I said, my goodness. So I'm thinking maybe he had a little too much to drink before his shift. That can't be all of Trinidad's reps, right? Just one bad apple. So I went to another company. I won't call the company, but the color was, right? And I'm looking at the reps and the things they're telling people. And I'm like, yo, this could never happen in Canada. Could never happen at Apple, where you're just making things up to sell a product, right? But everybody seems to be just making things up to sell. And then I thought to myself, well, back in Canada, if I wanted to learn about technology, I could go into an Apple store. There's workshops, right? You could go into TELUS or Rogers. There's workshops. People are teaching you how to use your devices. You can go into an Apple store right now and take a class on how to create games for Apple, how to do smartphone photography. All of these things are happening. And I thought, where is that in Trinidad? When I jump on Google, when I jump on YouTube, and I'm looking for where is the information specific to Trinidad and Tobago? Where is the information about tech specific to the Caribbean? And I realized there's nobody talking about tech. And when you jump on any of the media platforms, a lot of the information is stuff from the US, the UK, it's everywhere else. Nothing relative to us. Because I love tech and I like to teach, I thought to myself, well, maybe I could start a blog, because I wasn't going to do video, right? Maybe I could start a blog and I could start teaching people about the technology. But first, I had to learn how to build a website. So I learned how to build a website. After I built the website, I then started to learn, how do I get my content in front of as many eyeballs as possible? And in learning how to build my tech blog, I started to just gain skills in the digital space. When I released an article in 2016 with my brand, Droid Island, CNC3 was actually the first place that called and said, hey, we've been reading your articles. We love it. We want to feature you on Tech Thursday. And at that point, that planted the seed that the stuff that I'm doing online, people are also picking up in the media. And if you want to educate and if you want to reach people, you need to be where the people are. And you might think, you'll hear people say, you got to do this or you got to do that. If you really want to build a business and your brand, your message is a business, you need to treat what you're doing as a business, then you need to learn how to implement everything. Tova started off by saying traditional media has converged into digital. Traditional media has a lot of digital benefits that nobody's telling you about. Do you know what the biggest news platform is in the world? Just show of hands, anybody know what the biggest news platform is in the world? That is Apple News. Apple News is the biggest news platform, right? They carry news from all over the world on that platform. People subscribe to Apple News. Google News is another major news platform because they're pulling in all of the news from everywhere in the world. And the only way to show up in the two biggest news platforms is you have to be creating content for a media house. So fast forward a couple of years, I have my tech blog. I decided, you know what, more people are asking me about how I'm building the online presence of the tech blog, and then I opened up a physical store. More people wanted to know how I was building that business. And I realized there wasn't any place I could go locally that's teaching you about e-commerce, teaching you about digital marketing and more, right? The pandemic hits. And by when the pandemic hit, I already had so much information about e-commerce, digital marketing, building your business online, that the pandemic just skyrocketed my entire brand to another level. Because now I'm doing workshops in the UK, I'm doing workshops in the States, I'm doing workshops back home in Canada, I'm doing workshops around the region. So I decided to focus all of my energy on now teaching people in the Caribbean and the diaspora about how to build their business online. What are all the platforms and tools that you need to use in order to build your business online? And how do you integrate every single channel from newspapers to radio, TV, to blogs, to podcasts, to Google Web Stories, to Apple News, Google? How do you integrate all of these things to build your business? And I did not wait for media to come to me again. I had no intentions of coming to media. But because I was blogging, when I started to write for two media houses, a media house in Trinidad and I write for a media house in Jamaica, when I started to write, they reached out and they're like, hey, how do we get your content on our publications? I said, well, just say the word. My thing is, and Sonny talked about there's no money in media. He's right to a good extent, but there's plenty of things that you can do and opportunities for you to build this brand that generates income opportunities for you, right? So I've got a branded column called Digipreneur in two media houses, so it's in papers. Again, a lot of people don't know about the convergence because when you write for the papers, when it comes to the search engines, the media houses are able to rank on page one top five listings when you have your content in the papers. When you need information, where's the first place you go? You Google it, right? Anybody using AI tools? ChatGPT, Google Gemini. Where do those AI tools get their information? From the internet. So when you're not creating content and having your blog in these things, you're not even showing up in the number one place that people go to get information, and also you're not showing up in the AI tools as well. When you're on radio, we live stream. We can turn these audio episodes into podcast episodes after. That's a digital benefit. When radio reached out, I already had a podcast, and because they were seeing what the podcast was doing, it was a no-brainer to do something on radio. When I got the opportunity to do TV, I didn't apply for TV. It was because of all the video content I was doing on YouTube. So when they reached out and they're like, hey, how can we get your video content to work with what we're doing on CNC3? I said, listen, as long as we can do a branded segment, so everything I do, print, digital, when radio is a little bit different, but TV, it's all the Digipreneur brand, my brand. So we've had a now branded column, we have a branded TV segment, and it all allows me to be in both the traditional spaces and the digital spaces. So we don't have all the time in the world, but I want to wrap by saying this, and maybe I could take a question. To break into media, you don't have to wait. You don't have to wait for an opportunity to present itself. You could apply, sure, but what you should be doing is you have all the tools and channels right now to do video, to do a podcast, to write. If you want to get into print, start a blog. If you want to get into radio, start a podcast. If you want to get into TV, start doing video on YouTube, not just social media, right? Because social media isn't searchable. When people are trying to get information, and if you're somebody who has a business or a message, people are going to jump on Google and ask a question. And it's always going to be content from a website that shows up, or video content, or even audio content from a podcast. So you want to be where people are doing that search. Don't wait for the opportunity, just start. Start blogging. If you don't have a website, start using medium.com and start to just create your profile and start to write just to get out there. Because when media comes to you, you have some leverage because you're already doing it. You have something to present. They know exactly what they're getting into when they bring you on their platform because you have that body of work. Don't show up to that interview or that call empty-handed. Start building your portfolio because they're always looking. They're always looking for who is doing what. Who can we bring in to write in the papers? Who can we bring on radio? And your work is going to speak for itself. So don't wait. Start doing and building your portfolio now. And then when you get the call or when you go and apply, or when you go and pitch, you have something to show and you will do a lot better. You have a better chance of landing something in media when you're coming to the table with a body of work than somebody who just learned about getting into media and now they're trying to get their feet wet here. You've been doing it. You got your reps up. So that's it for me. Thank you. I was speaking to someone a little while ago.